Okay, guys, so 61. 61, I think, is also the difficult problem in this test. I mean, although you can guess the answer correctly, but it's hard to do all the derivation and the it's hard to go the deviation in the test. Okay, so all you need to remember is that the important is that any non-empty set A its power set has larger equality than A. Okay, this is the first one. The second one you need to remember is the power set of all the countable. Basically, this is the same as a real number. You need to remember two of these common fact, so you can answer this very quickly, or you may answer it quickly. So A is the R. How about B? All the function from Z to Z. So Z is countable. So basically this is all the function to N to N. And for each N, you can choose N. So basically you have infinite product of N. And this is the fact that you need to remember that infinite product of N is just the same as R. So we know that 1 and 2 cannot be correct. So third one is a function from R to R. Basically this is very large. Function from R to R is just basically the same as this. It's 2 to the power of R. Okay, because for each R because for function from R to 0, 1 means that, not function to R to R, function to 0, 1 means that you can, if it's 0, then I can say not choose. If it's 1, I say choose. So basically, function from R to 0, 1, the cardinality is just power set of R. And power set of R is larger than R. Okay, so number 4, all finite subsets. We don't have to care about it because finite subset of R definitely will smaller than the C. And we already know that A, B are definitely smaller than C, but we don't know that D is exactly smaller than C, but we know it's finite subset. And that in the C case then we don't care about whether it's finite. So C is still larger than D. So D cannot be the choice. How about E? The set of all polynomials with coefficient R. You can prove this. Basically, when you do the polynomial, since the polynomial is countable, so basically you can just count the first degree and count second degree, count third degree number of polynomials and add them together. So you can check that the number of polynomial, the cardinality of the polynomial ring, basically just the same as the ring. It's same as the field before. It's cardinality. Because you can count the first degree and it's count the second degree and you just add all of that. And then this counting process is countable. So basically you just add the countable real numbers. And the result is still R. So basically we choose C. So this is the answer.